Jesus in many ways be parallels in the Old Testament, a glimpse and a foreshadowing of the relationship between Christ and his father. It's exemplified in the details of Joseph's relationship with his father. Jacob is the patriarch, and he is taking time out of his schedule to take a needle and thread to stitch a garment.
All right.
Out of character for Jacob to turn into a tailor and make a garment for his son. But Joseph has been handpicked for a divine purpose.
Yes.
And since God allowed you to cross over in the year of 2013, you need to know and understand that God has handpicked me for a divine purpose. I'm not just here by chance. I'm not just here because I'm so smart. But I'm here because of God's divine purpose. Anybody can recognize your value and your worth once you've already got there. Anybody can recognize your worth once you come into your prophetic revelation cell. They'll applaud you and say, I knew it all the time. They said that they'll say, I can see it coming. Or I knew you'd get there. But you see, you need somebody in this season to be there in the season of obscurity.
Watch out.
I don't need a parade when I get there. But I need people that are pushing me before I can even see it for myself to let me know that there's something greater ahead of you. Next, we have Joseph, who was blessed by God to a degree beyond human comprehension. He possesses the kind of favor that we preach about, but we seldom possess. And the question is asked to us in this year, can God trust you with favor? Can God trust you with favor? Or do you want it just to make the little people feel small?
Oh.
Understand that you will continue to be in the locker room of the church until you get your heart right. What is it about Joseph?
What is it?
Among all his brethren, that God sees something in his heart that causes him to be favored all of his life. He's favored by God. He's favored by his father. He's favored by Potiphar. But even in all that, he's still in trouble. But even in the trouble, he's got favor. I've been through something, but he didn't let it consume me. My God, what I love about God, this is the joy, is that he doesn't let me disobey him more than I'm able to suffer the consequences. So here we have Joseph. He's the beloved son of his father, as Christ is the beloved son of his father. The scriptures let us know that Jesus came to his own and his own received him not. Interesting. Joseph had a ministry that even when they put him in prison, he started ministering in the prison until there was a breakthrough in the prison. And then Christ goes down into the lower parts of the earth and he preaches to the souls in prison that they might be judged as men walking in the flesh.
Amen. Glory. Jesus.
So God does not make up your life as you go along. But he already knows the end from the beginning. He's already purposed for you to be blessed. Look at somebody and tell them, I am blessed.
I am blessed.
You need to understand that God is not reactive when it comes down to blessing you. You need to know that you are destined to be blessed. Look at somebody and tell them, I'm destined to be blessed. I'm destined to succeed. I'm destined to move ahead. I lectured. I think I'll preach for just a little while. I'm destined to move on. Look at the neighbor and say, neighbor, I'm reaching for something better. There are people that will hold you to 2012 and say that you can accomplish no more than what you've seen in 2012. But tell somebody, I'm reaching for something better. Number one, I'm coming out of the ditch. There's some things I've been in that people set up for themselves. They said, we got you. We got your number. But look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I'm coming out of the ditch. There's nothing that can hold me. The enemy can't even hold me. I believe that even on my worst day, I can still defeat the devil. I believe that my lowest state of depression, I still got enough power to defeat the enemy. Look at the neighbor and say, neighbor, I don't have a vow of poverty, but I have a vow of prosperity. My God, my God. When we look back over our lives, we're not necessarily happy about our history. Because sometimes you're not happy with where you are right now.